Hello, hello, everyone. This is Krendis, and welcome back to The Avenger and XCOM 2. By Firaxis Games, I guess I could also say. But, last mission, we successfully defended our... Well, I guess it would almost be, in the context of the game, the main Resistance headquarters, which, ironically, does not have any civilians there that could actually fight back. And that's a huge... That's not a criticism, I could say. It's not a logical criticism. Well, it's a criticism I could say personally, because I don't like how the Resistance's strength is not evoked, I guess is a really good way to put it. It's not evoked in actual gameplay mechanics. And I like it when you have a allied faction or force that actually is evoked or represented well in in-game mechanics. And that was one of my huge disappointments with XCOM 2 in general, because I was looking forward to that sort of thing, but whatever, that's fine. What I'm also looking forward to, oh, by the way, that doesn't diminish the quality of XCOM 2 in general. To me, that's in terms of a tier of complaint, that's slightly below the bad optimization, because the bad optimization is higher only because other people whined about it, justifiably, of course. But I didn't mind it myself, because I was like, oh, my computer can barely handle this anyway, so whatever. I mean, this just makes it worse. But ironically, this is the same computer, so I mean, after their patches, or after me patching my own computer in a way to speak, the game's pretty gorgeous. In any case, let's see here. We have our staff just relaxing right now. Bradford is speaking with them. I think in the living quarters, he's just saying it's really good that we didn't lose our resistance, because if we did, then XCOM wouldn't have anywhere to go. I think you'd say something kind of not really congratulatory, but just sort of like bittersweet like that, because that's the kind of gravelly, almost down-put person Bradford is nowadays. In any case, let's go back to the geoscape and stare at it. Let's just stare at it. Supplies, I don't know, I want to continue making contact. This is kind of pointless, because it's like, oh,
East Africa.
Great. We're gonna get income the month after this month, because we're now receiving our supply drop right now.
Coming through, Commander. Putting it on screen now.
You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month, Commander. I hope that your ongoing efforts will only lead to further success.
Squad member Jiang Lixin is in the... Well, in the Resistance headquarters, but I'm not going to get a squaddy. That's so not worth supplies. And Dr. Bafan. If I didn't have a scientist, this would be more tempting, but since I have a bonus scientist,
Commander,
in my opinion,
we have intel suggesting the aliens are working on developments that threaten our ability to stop the Avatar project. We can conduct guerrilla operations to disrupt one of these efforts, but we'll have to choose carefully. We don't have the resources to intercede everywhere.
I know exactly what I'm going to be countering here. Hunt XCOM. I kind of wish this... I mean, it's funny, because this is actually a story-esque mission, sort of, in the form that it has cutscenes and cinematics and whatnot, but it's completely not optional, sort of. It's optional in that you could avoid it, but it's not something you want to get. So it's actually kind of funny in terms of a presentation perspective. But that's what I'll be countering, because I don't want to deal with the hunt at UFO.
The Resistance has a hidden cache of resources stashed outside of Advent's reach.
I'll get that later.
That means we'll have to fly over and scan the area if we want to recover this stuff for ourselves.
Making contact. Yeah, look at that. The guy has a gun. Or one of the, well, a Resistance fighter was just seen with an assault rifle, so what are you doing?
regional contacts located.
Europe, I could go there, but I don't think I could see the bonuses yet. I'm gonna continue, just let's get control of Africa, then spread out from there. And Avenger, let's get our supplies too, because I could use them. I wonder how I could use them immediately. If I really wanted to make sure I don't have anyone dying from, like, just unlucky hits or something, nanoplate vest might be a decent idea. Okay, that was fast.
Commander, to aid in your efforts, we have gathered additional resources and staff at Resistance headquarters for your use.
So South Africa is the last part of Africa we don't have contact with.
Commander, we've utilized all of our available communications capacity.
That's
fine. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Ooh, okay. So... Oh, wait. Did I screw up? I mean, not screw up, but did I waste time? Okay, I did waste some time. Right. So... This is kind of dumb, but I'm actually gonna see okay. Yeah, I think getting Advanced War Center out would help. Not so much with Sentry or Scott, since I think Scott will actually be out just in time for the next mission. What did he get hit by? I don't remember. Whatever. I don't actually remember why Scott is in the infirmary. Is he faking? It says lightly wounded. I mean, he could be... I don't know if he's the type of person to say he got shot so he could try to go home or something. But I think we're finding
Commander, that's not entirely true.
To
make contact, but we'll have to make the first move.
Okay, yep.
The
Resistance Radio 11.
Research can only further our advances, Commander. Commander, with the Advent officer currently in cold storage, we should perform the autopsy as soon as possible.
The Avenger serves our purposes adequately in terms of coordinating our communications network, but if we hope to increase our range and reach every possible outlet, we'll have to do more. A series of carefully positioned relay towers would suffice, assuming we could miniaturize the technology we have adapted from the alien zone communications equipment. It may be difficult to balance the requisite power levels versus the increased chances of detection, but this is our best bet to expand our capabilities. With the increased coverage, we can expect the efficiency of local resistance operations to improve, even though it's still not reflected in game. Strengthening the groups working within the range of towers, even though, you know, that part's pretty much whatever. So this is the code name Project Marconi, and great, it's good because we can just this increases our income as well. I think, yeah, I'm pretty sure that's its primary purpose, but it also works toward achieving those continent bonuses. Oh, modular weapons, heck yes, because I think we do have an advanced stock, and I'd love to get that on a gun.
Commander, we can now construct radio relays in any region where we've made contact with the local resistance.
I guess we aren't getting that area excavated, but before that, I think I forgot to do the exact thing that I wanted to do, or I could, I don't think I'll be spending any supplies on buildable items right now. So yeah, let's just go ahead and just make the Advanced War Center. Yeah, well, an engineer would need to be inside the Advanced War Center to actually reduce their recovery time. I don't know. I mean, people getting an Advanced War Center perk, which is, well, a bonus ability outside the current class. That's pretty good, because we could get some crazy ones. What else can we make? I don't actually know. I think Advanced War Center is probably our best bet, just in case we...
Commander, we've pushed our current
power
systems
that.
To the limit. We don't have any capacity to spare, which means we can't expand our facilities further.
I know. We'll work on that after we're done with this guerrilla op. Commander, I know exactly what I'm countering, by the way. There is almost no question in this.
For support sites around the world. Unfortunately, we only have the resources to respond to one of them.
The decision is yours.
Oh my god, both these have such good names for our very first operation that I plan to bring Mateus out on. Now, East Africa is not really an option to me, but both of these have pretty good rewards. 142 supplies, that supplies are great. Not really helpful for a total overall. Well, it's not helpful on the level that this would be, which is Dr. Conrad Koenig. Yeah, and he's a scientist, and that would just further decrease our research time even below what we have it right now. But at the same time, if I go to East Africa, I would be putting a huge strain on my soldiers at that point, because I'm just gonna go with the assumption that if there is a hunt, a UFO that actually, if there's a UFO, we could evade it. Maybe. If we don't evade it, then we have to do a special mission, which involves getting away from the UFO. And that mission involves a lot of fighting. Thankfully, we have lots of good cover. So that's not the hardest mission in the world. But I mean, like, everyone's gonna take hits. I feel like everyone, and that's without the Advanced War Center. That's just not worth it to me. So yeah, I mean, I do want that scientist, but I don't want to deal with the UFO just yet. This is going to sound real arrogant.
Setting course for the West
but
sector.
I do feel like from a tactical perspective, I could beat the UFO mission even in early game. But at the same time, this game is, yes, it's definitely tactical. But yes, there's RNG involved as well. And I don't have enough ways to minimize that RNG just yet. I'm considering bringing a rookie on this mission because... Wait, no, it's ranked as moderate. No, let's bring Takahashi. Well, shoot. Maybe the rookie is the best choice. It's a timed mission. No, look, Takahashi will be able to destroy the relay from afar if we need to, because we can move someone, have side of the relay, and Takahashi can take some squad side shots at it, and it scales with our current day and time in terms of how strong it is. So it's not very strong right now at all, really. So Takahashi, yep, I'll be taking him. Galena, my goal with Galena is Sergeant before GTS finishes. Did GTS finish? 9 days, okay. So you have at least one mission, maybe two, to reach Sergeant. If I do, then we could, as soon as GTS finishes, we could get the, we could get a squad of five people up, and that will be nice. So yeah, we don't have a Grenadier, that sucks, because I don't know what the heck Ramirez is doing, but we need him back. So in the meantime, who's going to carry the Frost Bomb? I think Galena is the winner here. Everyone here is so immobile, if we want to maximize their ability anyways. Takahashi, Sniper, immobile. Galena, immobile, if I want to fire two shots in one turn. Schmidt actually is the most mobile. And just because I have him with the Boltcaster still, Mateus is also kind of immobile. And in terms of maximizing his magical ability, and yes, I will be using that word in a sci-fi game because the context of the mod, kind of immobile too. But we'll see. Now, I like this for Mateus' first operation as a corporal necromancer. Operation Shattered Corpse. I say, let's get those corpses up and see what we can do. The biggest issue I have with the Necromancer mod actually is the most iconic ability of a Necromancer. And maybe we'll see why exactly. We'll see. Maybe we will. Maybe we won't. Who knows? Do I have any custom? I don't have any. I should install a custom sniper rifle. Do I have modular weapons? I don't yet. Okay. So, no weapon upgrades. No anything. Fantastic. Let's just go then, I guess. Yeah, let's do it. So, well, we're on the way there. I do like the format of my episodes. I don't know if it would be better to do an action mission, well, a tactical mission, than a strategic mission, well, a strategic portion afterwards, but I don't know. I mean, I kind of like the lull in nothing, and then suddenly something happens. But then we could immediately see what that something is in this episode, rather than waiting until the next episode to see what that is.
Transmit critical data back to their network. The loss of that data will stop their latest project in its tracks. So we're moving in to destroy the relay before they complete the transfer. We're expecting a strong contingent of security forces. Neutralize them and secure the site. Destroy that relay at all costs.
Man, Galena, her face looks... She's been... I mean... She's been through some stuff. Let us begin. It almost looked like we flew directly through a building. Alright. Takahashi, Galena, Mateus, and...
The communications relay is up ahead. Move in and destroy the target.
Position concealed.
Alright, Stefania. Or is that Stefania? No, it's Stefania who looked a bit roughed up. Ouch. Okay. I will be moving Takahashi last. We have 8 turns to reach all the way over there. That'll be fun. We don't have any magical view of any advent forces, so we're just gonna have to move on up.
Position confirmed.
Mateus, anybody? No? Okay, then move up slightly. If we can make it to the truck, that'll be good.
Moving out.
You can, Mateus. Anybody? Still nothing, huh? Galena, follow up. A bit closer? Oh, you do see... Okay, this sectoid is like, I got this job.
Rolling.
And then I get all these cool drones just fly around. I don't crash them often, but this is really cool. 2 drones. Interesting. I could just shoot at them, or I could destroy them instantly. This sectoid. None of these people really pose much of a threat. Literally none of them do. Man, Galena is in a position to get 2 shots off as well. Yeah. Now, for the life of me, I actually did put Takahashi in a position where he's gonna have to take a shot from down here. I don't know why, but... Okay. We have 2 people we could react with. I think Takahashi's gonna go into Overwatch. This seems crazy, and it might be, just because of the fact that he's not in cover, but I could guarantee I could guarantee both kills on the drones if things really go bad, and yeah, I mean, that would just leave the sectoid, who is the one that's actually capable of killing Takahashi, but he might retreat, he might fight it out. I don't know. Is there any... Okay. Where's that sectoid? The sectoid's on the other side, isn't he? I'm pretty... I don't remember, but... I think he's on the other side, which is why we just are out of vision of him. Mateus, go over there and look, please. Oh, whoa, camera. Now, okay. I think we're gonna start with Mateus. Or, well, I want to start with Mateus because I don't know how high the drones, because this is a pack added mod. I mean, a mod pack added enemy. I don't know how high they are on an Overwatch priority. Yeah, that's what I meant. Which is to say, I don't know who exactly Mateus is going to fire an Overwatch shot at. We have a guaranteed hit. We have a 100% guaranteed hit on the Sectoid. I think that's too good to pass up. If I don't do anything... Oh, gosh. This is so tough. I'm going to have... Well, if Galena goes into Overwatch... Whatever. Yeah, whatever.
Yes,
worst comes to worst, I'm fine with using two combat protocols to clean this up. So we have two Overwatch shots on the drone, and one on the Sectoid. Well, we'll need one on the Sectoid too, I mean, so. Let's begin. Mateus, you might not get to use your necromantic things, especially if you just become such an awesome shooter like this. All right, what you gonna do? That's a kill, I like that. It's a not kill, but I still like that.
We're off the armor.
So that's three. Combat protocol on the surveillance drone, and then I think we just go into Overwatch and take our chance with the drone doing whatever it wants to do. Or right. Is it retreating, really? Not what I thought it would do.
I'm on the move.
Interesting.
Двигаюсь на позицию.
Very interesting.
Bin schon unterwegs.
Follow it.
Good copy. Moving on target.
If this does max damage, it will kill it. Sure. Wow.
Target neutralized.
Takahashi, that's... Good shot. Oh my goodness, I am so tempted to make Takahashi a gunslinger just because of that. A failed hack will result in all enemies getting a defensive and mobility boost, or recover a small cache of intel. No thanks, not doing any of that. I don't want any of that. That's not worth buffing my enemies. No, that's worth nothing. Now, do we move up slightly?
Let's rock.
I'm not moving up slightly. Forget that. We're right in front of the building that has the transmitter. Overwatch all. Maybe they'll patrol into us. Maybe they'll do nothing just like that. But that's okay. Because I can move in and pick this up. Or maybe I move in first with Mateus.
Moving.
And that got me nothing. Who is fine with staying
closing
back here?
Target position now.
I guess Takahashi would be. Illyrium core, love it.
I'm sure the docs will want to see this.
We gotta keep moving in. I need someone to move up close enough to be kind of where that patrol car is, because then Takahashi actually should have a beat on it. Yeah, they will. If I move slightly, what about right here? If I fire from here. No, there's a wall in the way. I gotta move one tile over to the left.
Orders confirmed, moving out.
I mean, if I'm gonna fire on there, I don't really need to have my aim steadied anyways, so, or aim.
Slushies.
Or, oh shoot, this is not good. Okay. This is, shoot, that was not ideal. That was pretty bad, actually. Mateus, do something. I don't know what you're gonna do. I see a potential kill on the sectoid, but he's not our biggest problem right now. Our biggest problem would be in the form of that officer back there. Wait, no, these are just troopers. Okay. Interesting. If I don't fire the bolt caster at the sectoid, I don't know what else I would do instead. Retreating not gonna really help us here, so I guess, yeah, let's blast the sectoid if we can. 7 damage. We can't pick up a kill on that, unfortunately. Unless we grenade him. I'm not doing that though. Okay, well, that was a moot point. Yikes. They don't have grenades. The sectoid's probably just gonna use his crazy mind powers. What kind of shots do you have on them? They're both behind full cover. I don't really want to use a grenade on them. I could flashbang them just so they have really lousy aim. That seems the most... I mean, I don't have... But that will mean the sectoid is going to fire. And this is one of the weird cases where I actually don't want the sectoid to fire. But that means I won't have the grenade for later. But we're behind half cover, so... I don't know if I want to risk them taking, fully unbuffed shots at us. We have the frostbang, we have the frost bomb grenade. We should be fine. I am going to intentionally let the sectoid not get hit. Because then he's just most likely going to use a psionic power. And now... Now, Galena can do whatever she wants. So guys, what you gonna do? What is this? Oh, geez. Mateus, that's not cool. But stay cool, Mateus. Overwatch and taking a shot. Those are so close, it's scary as hell.
It's nothing.
What's in my, I heard that as what's in my muffin. So, Galena, you have 2 actions here. Go ahead and take the first one at the troop. That did that break Overwatch? It did, so we can move freely. Why didn't I just shoot there instead? Oh well. Oh, it's because Galena doesn't have line of sight of there. I am thinking of shooting the gas tank and seeing what happens. The sectoid might be close enough to get blown up by it. I mean, if I do it with Stefania, worst comes to worst, I could just move in with Junichi and then toss the grenade at the sectoid. I could move Junichi slightly over just so he'll be able to get
over now.
Yeah, I'm doing that is what I mean. So from here you have a shot at the gas barrel, if I understand this correctly. Okay. And doesn't matter what happens here. What is that 1 damage? Okay, well, great. Sectoid's gonna blow up.
Take this!
So frag out. Frag out and... Last but not least, 35%. Or... Oh, he still has his full turn, sweet. Or, what is this? 44%. Both are terrible.
Ready to engage!
Galena, I would like a kill with you just because I want you to rank up. But this is nice. I mean, nice thing about poison is it's one damage, but it's guaranteed damage. What's going to happen here is he is now going to be poisoned and take damage on his turn, and then it's one damage, so goodbye, buddy. He just, well, basically poisoned out.
The alien transmission,
I know, Bradford, we're fine.
Running out of time. Get to the relay and take it out.
We're fine.
ASAP.
Don't worry.
Enemy moving on our position.
That's not cool. But that is okay. Stefania, move in slightly, not too far, just enough to get a view on that thing. Yes, that thing. That's what I meant. I mean, we could just shoot at it right now. I don't see any reason not to. The only reason I would not to is just to get more of an Overwatch advantage on this group that's dropping right now. Which actually isn't the worst idea in the world. At all, really. In fact, it's a pretty good idea. Where is the flare? The flare is right in front of us, okay. Okay.
Moving out.
I'm sticking everyone behind around this truck because I'm just so worried about triggering another group that I don't want to deal with it. Yeah, I think we go ahead and do this because we can get some reloads off, some Overwatch shots off. We're in a really good position to deal with them right now and not deal with them later. And last but not least, this is a chance for Takahashi to actually shoot with a sniper rifle. The first sniper round shot of, I think, the mission. So, I'll take it. So what do we got? Two troopers, one officer. You probably should request a drop not directly into the zone, because that was a bad idea.
Lux.
Goodbye, buddy. Ouch. This place is getting shot up real badly. Oh, sorry, guys.
Bedrohung ausgeschaltet.
Promotion earned. Did Stefania just outrank Galena? I think she did. Well, it doesn't really matter so long as someone gets promoted. Mateus, getting you a kill is tempting. So much so that I'm going to do it. Damn, Mateus.
Target neutralized.
Damn, Mateus. Yeah, just shoot. Let's do it.
Die Waffe verschlingt meine Munition.
Takahashi can finish it off, and then Galena can go to Overwatch. Galena, who I wanted to rank up, does not rank up, but Stefania does, and is now our first sergeant. So, damn, Galena. What are you doing as the rifleman? So many explosions, hate it. Well, I like explosions, but not when they're so close.
Eat you.
Galena, don't do anything. What is this? What's the bonus here? Let's see if it's lousy as the first one. It is just as bad as the first one. I could have sworn they deviated from outpost to outpost on every mission, but maybe they're the same on every mission. I don't know. I don't think that's the case, though. That doesn't make any sense to me. Because that just seems like a really base thing, I guess. Or a really undeveloped thing, I would almost say, if that's the case. But I don't think it's that way. I'm pretty sure it's not. Instead of overwatching, I'm going to raise a zombie and Let me show why I consider this a fairly powerful class, to the point of it being perhaps, covering now. Perhaps slightly imbalanced. And what is corpse explosion? Oh, cool. It would be this. Necromancer zombie can now... He's on fire, but I don't care. He is moving forward and triggering a group who will go into this building, and they happen to see the necromancer zombie, but I don't care. And the necromancer zombie cannot use cover. But again, that's perfectly fine. And basically what I mean is it's another unit on the field for them to shoot at. And that makes it exceptionally powerful. I'm not going to take this shot, and instead I'm going to steady my weapon. So, Galena, move up slightly. Full cover's good, especially when advancing. No, move over there, please. Oh, Jesus! Ah! Okay, that's the finicky controls. Not controls. I guess you could say they are controls, but they also are not at the same time. But I guess that's okay. I could have Stefani move over there. But I mean, like, you cannot move it. You can't even so much as breathe on the mouse when it's like this finicky, because if you move slightly over, it's like, oh, you mean there. No, I mean up here. But yeah, when you're trying to make movements kind of in a fast manner, which I shouldn't, because there's no real reason to rush. So I do need line of sight in order to use combat protocol. Good to know. Direct line of sight with the soldier in question, that I want to have them use combat protocol. It's not like 8 protocol, except with enemies instead. But that's unfortunate, but that's okay. That is perfectly fine, because we're still gonna make this work. I mean, it's a decent group. Not gonna lie. I wish I could tell my soldiers. Well, maybe I don't, because this would just be an extra layer of micromanaging I would need to do. But I wish I could say, hey, don't shoot the drone, because it's just gonna blow up. You're on fire, and then you're gonna get shot at. Oh no. Yeah, this is what I did not want. It's like, he's taking the zombie's job right now of getting shot and stunned with really kind of lame graphics. Especially in practice, I shouldn't say that. Oh, that's unfortunate. Quite unfortunate. But yeah, that is pretty much... That's why I think the Necromancer is strong. It's like they just wasted all of that. And additionally, it could do damage. It definitely could do damage. I say we just overwatch and let them come to us. It's not going to be free shots, but... I mean, they're basically going to have to do... They're going to have to take overwatch shots as they advance at us, is what I mean. Like so. Who was that? Oh, that's the truth. Well, he's dead now. Next! No, just don't shoot at the drone. Let the drone do whatever it wants. Oh. So wasteful. I mean, it's dead, but so very wasteful. Because now we have this officer. Wait. We don't have an officer? Huh.
Incoming over here!
Okay. I guess I'm crazy. Galena. We're gonna set this up for you real well, alright? Mateus moves in, tosses the grenade. And maybe it'll kill. Well, Mateus. Okay, good. Mateus didn't rank up yet. if they rank up, there's going to be a plus sign next to their icon up in the bottom left here. So Stefania, you know, the plus sign there. It looks like a red. I mean, it looks like a cross almost. I was going to say red cross, but it doesn't look like a red cross. It's more like a blue or a white cross. Anyways, yeah, it just means they ranked up. So any other further kills on a mission, I don't think that XP contributes to the, well, their next rank until they are said rank. I don't think it does, because I've never seen a situation where soldiers had multiple ranks, even when they've done a lot of killing of high experience rewarding enemies. And for all I know, like, experience rewards just might be baseline. They might not be like, oh, you get more for killing an officer, or oh, you get more for killing a trooper than a drone or something like that. Galena, 75%, do it. Sweet. And we're still not done. This is so kind of cheap, but I don't care. What's gonna happen right now is I'm gonna hack. Because I can't imagine there's that many enemies left. So if I lose this, whatever. Like, you get a defense and mobility boost. We have every ability up cooldown. We're in a good position to just shoot you. And we have a lot of ammo left. So there was an officer. Who did you shoot earlier? Or was it this guy that got shot? It was him. Oh god. Okay. Wait. How did you manage that? What in the hell? What just happened? I don't understand that, actually. I don't really know how he managed that. That doesn't make any sense to me. So you moved, fired, and then moved again? Like, there is no moving Overwatch as far as I'm aware. That was not something I took into consideration at all. And that really bites a lot. Damn, this is why I wish there's a combat log, because, like, what in the world happened there? Like, did XCOM happen there? I probably should have put him behind full cover, though, so. Yeah, that's just something I didn't think about or consider. But you know what?
We're green to go.
You're going straight to hell. Let's end it. Son of a SOB.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Two soldiers killed. Oh, right. Because of the zombie, they count as soldiers. But that is really... What in the world was that? Literally the worst necromancer zombie. That's sad. Because he's a zombie. What in the world could that have been? Like, I get that you just moved somewhere and then fired. But moving afterwards? I guess... At the end of the day, he's still probably gonna get the kill, but damn, that's terrible. And after I was so we didn't increase his aim, is the thing. It was defense and mobility, so he would just be harder to hit. Increasing his mobility doesn't give him another action, it just means he can move farther and possibly flank us. But he didn't do that. He just shot us right through half cover. That's terrible. I don't even know what that was. but I shouldn't have left him in half cover. I really didn't consider that at all. That's terrible. That's my fault. Damn it, Takahashi. I feel terrible about that. But we'll do our best to press on without him. We will have to get a replacement sniper, though, because I still want one. More important than that, not to say that getting a sniper isn't important, but I need a shinobi. So, let's see. And they can critically hit. So, Galena actually could overwatch pretty well. Five critical chance adds up quite a bit, especially when surrounded, but I don't want to be surrounded, so at the most, this will be at like a 15% critical chance. With a rifleman, that's not bad, because riflemen don't get... I mean, combined with light 'em up, this could be pretty good, now that I think about it. Yeah, I mean, I say aggression, sure. Will to survive could be good. Suppression is situational, but it could be good. I mean, all those abilities seem pretty nice. So Schmidt, our first actual sergeant. Let's see here. We didn't lose a sergeant, that's good, of course, but damn, Takahashi. Not gonna be over that for a while. At all. Ugh. Overwatch shots can now be triggered by any enemy movement action, not just movement. I don't know how, I mean, that's actually decent. Because if they don't move, then we can still get an overwatch shot at them. So that's not bad. But flashbanger is pretty good too. Smoker is also tempting just because I don't really want to be using smoke grenades. Which is to say, I don't want to be bringing them along, so I think Smoker will give us an additional smoke grenade, even if we don't bring one along, so it could be nice. But Flashbangs, it gives us another ability to use offensively, disorient them, break, mind control, whatnot. So yeah, I'll do Flashbanger. Although covering fire was very tempting, very tempting. Takahashi only came along for two missions, and I didn't actually finish editing them. So geez. Dour. Very dour.
Hello, Commander.
But that's okay, we gotta keep on going. Yeah,
Commander? Dad sacrificed the only thing he had left to get this ship off the ground. And I won't let it be for nothing. She might be a little worse for wear right now, but with some new schematics and a little elbow grease, she'll be the toughest thing in the sky.
Janine? I am still hard at work on the current research priority, Commander.
We've done what we can to honor our fallen soldiers, Commander. It's not much, but it gives our people a chance to pay their respects.
Advent mag rifle, huh? Yikes. But yeah, let's see. Fallen. Let's see. What should I write here? Thinking. Fallen due to... I almost want to say hubris. sure? Okay. Fallen due to hubris. In death, may he find peace. So, Junichi Takahashi, the samurai, does mark our first casualty by an Advent officer. And it was a really weird move, too. I don't know if that just happened all at once, but at the end of the day, yeah. It's possible, yeah, the Advent officer couldn't have crit, but that's what happened. So, yeah. That's just something we'll have to live with. So, with that said,
new orders, Commander?
I definitely think taking a break is a bit in order. Recuperating, especially after that mission. It was fine.
Work is well underway, Commander.
Up until I decided to just...
I must admit,
just be careless, I guess.
Having successfully completed the operation necessary to remove the Commander's implant, I am intrigued by the possibility of examining another subject for comparative analysis. Since the officer in question will likely have expired long before arrival here, I may rely on a faster, more invasive approach to removing the chip this time around.
Yeah, it was just such a, he died due to hubris. That's pretty much all I could say about that, really. I pretty much thought we won the battle. I didn't know who that was. I knew there was an officer part of that group, but for some reason I thought he was already dead. Because I saw the body on the ground, but as it turns out, that body wasn't the one we just shot. He just got out of sight so quickly. I was like, oh, he's dead. But yeah, it's rough. It's just rough. But yeah, we'll definitely remember Takahashi. And with that said, I will see everyone later. Tune back in for more XCOM 2 on the next episode.